Hey everybody, TK8305, back from the dead, literally and figuratively. Yay! Anyways, just so you guys know, this Genshin Impact video will be going up after the Lost Belt 5.1 videos are done for FGO, so yeah. Should be popping up probably nearing mid-December, I'm guessing. That's a rough estimate, I'm only guessing, I might not be right. Anyways, I wanted to do a Genshin Impact video for the longest time, and I've decided since I've unlocked Hu-Tao's main story in the game, now would be a perfect time to record a video, so yeah. Let's delve right into it, folks. Loading game, please load faster. Yeah, I'm using a brand new screen recorder. I decided to get away from OBS on my old machine. Now that I'm on my dad's computer, which is now mine, I've decided to go with a new screen capture program called, I believe it was FBX, as I tried to look up a good video recorder for Genshin, and this one, FBX came up, so I decided to roll with it, and it's pretty easy to use. And I managed to get the game running in 60 frames per second, and it looks very beautiful. Hopefully it turns out that way for you guys. Okay. Look at that squirrel, or ferret, or whatever it is. Maybe it's a ferret from Pokemon, I don't know. Anyways, I figured I'd show you the four Kesta characters I'm using. I got Noelle, she's a claymore user. Big-ass sword. And then we got Xingq. He's a nerd, as Piccolo would say. Loves to read a lot of books. And he's a sword fighter. Very quick with the sword, as you can see. And he's a water-based fighter. And then we got Chi-Chi, five-star character. She's a ice zombie. And she too uses a sword. Quite proficient with it. And last but not least, the love of my life, the number one waifu in Genshin for me, Hu-Tao. And she uses a pole arm. And she's a pyro user. And she is the cutie. Look at her go. All fancy-smancy with that pole arm. Yeah, she's got the staff of Homa also. Don't ask how much money I spent. It was painful. But I got what I wanted in the end. Damn gotcha. Anyhow, let's go to activate Hu-Tao's quest. If I haven't already, I do have it open, okay. So now we just gotta get to the right location. Go to Wu-Wang Hill. Let's see if I can find a teleporter nearby. Let's go over to this spot. The Serena Teapot. Don't mind that. Wu-Wang Hill. I'm in the right spot. Now I gotta go south. Yeah, that little beacon of light that hovers around your blue arrow in the map screen, that tells you where you're going. And I don't want to go in there, no. Don't mind me, I'm trying to get myself in the right direction. Yeah, where that little beam of light is in the background, with the numbers and the miles you have to travel, yeah, go towards that. Let's go to Noel, activate the story.
Why did we come here? Paimon's got a bad feeling about this. Not that Paimon's scared or anything, just, concerned for your safety. It's just that this is how lots of scary stories go. You're in an empty place, in the middle of nowhere, there's barely any light, and then just when you least expect it, a stranger comes out of... quick, do something!
Didn't you say you weren't scared?
Paimon's intuition says that anyone we run into here is going to be far from normal. If he gets us, he's gonna eat Paimon for sure.
Who are you?
He'd have to have a pretty big mouth for that to happen, Paimon. I came from beyond the heavens.
Beyond the heavens? A strange way of putting it. Don't try to scare me. I'm just here for a funeral. I don't mean to offend. No matter who you are, there's no need for any ill will between us.
Whew. Seems he's just your average scaredy cat. He looks more afraid than Paimon.
But you're kind of terrifying, too.
Huh? Am not! Paimon's super friendly looking! Don't be afraid. We come in peace.
Gods protect me!
No! Stop freaking out and stand still! Relax!
Relax? Yes, whatever you say. Please, stay your hand. Don't come any closer. I mean you no harm. Don't! Don't touch me!
Hey! Pyro already said nothing's gonna happen!
He's not a very good listener, apparently. Yet the butterfly flutters away, started.
Was it something Paimon said?
Maybe.
Let's go after him. He might do something stupid.
That's always a possibility, too. And I just picked up a sweet flower. It's basically an ascension item for one of your characters. Whom? I'm not sure. I just collect them. Let's see. He's over here. There you are!
Director! Director! There's a ghost after me!
Oh? Don't get too excited. These are clients, not ghosts.
Exactly! We said we're not ghosts! Why won't you calm down and let us explain? Although, clients doesn't seem quite right either.
Forgive me. This is one of our new undertakers, Meng. It's his first time working a funeral, so of course he's afraid of his own shadow.
Funeral... Oh! The Wangsheng Funeral Parlor! Zhang Li is a consultant there! They deal with this stuff a lot, right?
Oh, you know Zhang Li? Well, that saves me a lot of explaining. I'm Hu-Tao, the current director of the Wangsheng Funeral Parlor, responsible for, trifling matters having to do with immortality.
Marry me!
It's a satisfying trade to be in, though, and Wangsheng Funeral Parlor is well known around town. Whatever the request, I'd be glad to hear it.
And somewhere Azur Blaziken is pulling my ear away. I don't think we fall into the client category.
Yeah, if we were looking for Wangsheng Funeral Parlor's help, this is hardly the place we would come to.
But you see, I wasn't referring to clients in the business sense. Everyone who enters this mortal realm will be a client of mine. Sooner or later.
Well, that's dark.
Wangsheng Funeral Parlor welcomes advanced reservations. When you choose us, you'll never have to worry about what might be around the corner. But be sure to book the right date. Pro tip, it is a living nightmare trying to get flowers at short notice. Speaking of dates, if you're struggling to decide, please do come and talk it over. I'd hate to see you still alive and kicking when your big day comes.
Whoa, slow down. That's... you... There's a lot to unpack here.
That all sounded very bizarre.
You'll have to excuse her. The director is a rather unique individual. Allow me to explain. We'd heard that there'd been some supernatural activity at Wuwong Hill. To restore calm here, we performed a funeral ceremony. It went very smoothly. According to the director, we shouldn't be expecting any more issues in the near future.
Wangsheng Funeral Parlor, Wuwong Hill, funeral... What more is there to say? These three belong in the same sentence. You two, on the other hand, have no business coming to Wuwong Hill. You being here is not normal.
Maybe your understanding of normal isn't quite normal.
I'm here on an adventure.
Adventure? You must hail from the Adventurers Guild. Then you are one of our distinguished clients. What, to be precise?
Would? What do you mean?
That's just how we gauge our clients' importance. We have four levels. Wicker, bamboo, wood, and marble. The higher the grade, the better we'd like to get to know you.
But I've just only heard of this.
Well, that's because I only just thought of it. Oh, don't look so shocked. Oh, take a look. Our adventurers spend the whole day scaling mountains, clearing domains, and smiting enemies. Danger and peril are their bread and butter. Clients like these deserve better treatment. Taking an interest in their daily lives will ultimately benefit not only them, but also me.
Charming.
Touched a nerve, did I? I'd have thought any adventurers who dare come here would be used to conversations like this. Anyway, I have a favor to ask. Recently, Wangsheng Funeral Parlor has been trying to strike a business deal with the Adventurers Guild. With you acting as an intermediary, it would be so much easier.
What's in it for me?
Let me think what I could offer you as a reward. Or perhaps there's a favor I could do in return?
Ah, we're looking for someone. We've asked a lot of people, but nobody seems to have a clue where they are.
This seems like something right up my alley. I can even inquire with the ones who no longer speak for you. You see? Helping me will be worth your while. Come on then, my able assistants. Let's get down to Liyue Harbor and do some business.
When did we become your assistants? Wangsheng Funeral Parlor. The ones who no longer speak.
Oh,
did she mean talking to the dead?
I don't know, Paimon.
She's a weird one.
I like weird. I'm weird myself, so we tend to get along. Anyway. Oh god, 2,335 miles? I don't even know what I'm saying. Sorry, I'm caught up in all the beautiful scenery here. Now we're going south. Yeah, we're taking a teleporter. No way in hell are we running all the way over there. Yeah, big fat waste of time. Alright, we're in Liyue Harbor. Now we just follow the sparkly trail. And that should take us to Hu-Tao, apparently. And there she is. Oh, wait. Hu-Tao meeting Hu-Tao! Ah! There's a clone running around.
Ugh, you again. Look, I told you, we're not interested in the kind of cooperation you describe.
Come on, there's no reason to get upset. Look, one of your members is an avid supporter of my proposition.
Just hear her out.
Oh, since our last negotiation, I've come up with a new proposal, which I think you'll find has far more benefits for you. First things first, Wangsheng Funeral Parlor will prioritize the Adventurers Guild requests above all others. You'll also receive 100 of our signature wooden coffins for free, together with your first order. That's not all. We also provide an on-site cadaver collection service covering almost all regions in Liyue. Now, we do charge a slight premium for a very small number of especially dangerous areas, but don't you worry about that. I promise you, it's still very affordable.
I don't think you're hearing me.
Okay, all right. I get it. You want to bargain a little more. But our offer as it stands is already quite a good deal, don't you think? Just think about it. An adventurer's life is full of unexpected threats. It's only natural to take precautions. Mend the roof before it rains, as they say.
Yeah, no. I'm not so sure that saying applies in this context. Speaking of precautions, I'd rather focus on keeping my adventurers safe in the first place. It's time for you to go. I have to attend to other matters.
Wait, hold on! What would you say to a group discount? 30% off for parties of 10?
Director, please, you did your best. We don't need another clash with the Millilith.
If Paimon understood all that correctly, it seems like she's trying to sell them the funeral parlor services.
This will get us nowhere.
Yeah, nothing left to do here. Let's go back to Wangsheng Funeral Parlor. Rejecting a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. It's their loss.
Yep. Don't worry, Hu-Tao.
Some things are inevitable. It's only a matter of time.
It's okay, Hu-Tao. I will be your client. Whenever I'm in the ground, I will be sure to have your services, I'll be sure to purchase your services before I go. I want to be buried by that cutie. Anyways. I'm going the wrong way. Sometimes playing and talking in this game, they don't mix very well. My next destination, where do I go? Where we go? No, that's way up in Mondstadt. We don't want to go that way. Down here. Oh. Well, I'm not too far off from the destination. Yeah, I'll take this teleporter. It's right there. Yeah, I'm trying to come up with things to talk about. Just give me a few minutes. I mean, I haven't recorded a game video in, like, what, since, like, maybe late 2019? It's been that long, so... I'm a bit rusty with my commentary, so bear with me. But what I could tell you, though, is I love Hu-Tao's English voice actress. Brianna Knickerbocker. I follow her on Twitter, and she liked a few of my tweets, too, so... already had some slight interaction.
Seems like the old ways are the most reliable after all. Mung, are you done preparing our promotional materials?
My apologies. I'm only about halfway through. Do you really think they will be effective?
Trust me, they're going to work wonders. This marketing strategy has been used by Wangsheng Funeral Parlor for generations. Clients in need come to our door and write down their commissions on blank wooden tiles. Then they squeeze those inside the parlor through the crack under the door. I fulfill the request written on each tile to make sure our clients are satisfied with the service, no matter if it's an obituary, cremation, or funeral that they seek. Although, it is a bit of a hassle with the constant back and forth. If only we could burn them by the batch.
No, Director, I'm not asking about the wooden tiles themselves, but about the special offer they advertise.
Special offer?
Wangsheng Funeral Parlor should keep up with the times. Just think about it. If we don't attract new clients, we'll be left with nothing, won't we? Business development is a crucial element of every prosperous enterprise. I've been trying various marketing strategies ever since I became the director. I put up posters just like all the other shops, but the Millilith promptly removed them. Then I organized the Wangsheng Visitor's Day, but no one showed up.
Well, that doesn't come as a huge surprise.
And finally, I discovered that the traditional ways are the most reliable after all. I took inspiration from the wisdom of previous directors. So now, I go from door to door looking for people and organizations willing to cooperate. Just like during our visit to the Adventurers Guild. That's what I mean by business development. The other method I'm trying is using the wooden tiles as coupons. Just by writing things like, buy one, get one free for the holder of this tile on them.
What do they buy and what do they get?
A solid and durable second home, of course. Well, they may not need it right away, but they can be sure that when they do, it will still be as good as new. It won't start deteriorating before you finish doing so yourself. That's the Wangsheng Funeral Parlor quality guarantee.
I don't know what to say to that.
All right, Mom. Keep adding those special offers to the wooden tiles. The future of our business depends on it.
I'm still not sure this will work.
Oh, I get it. You think that our special offer is not comprehensive enough, right? It is true. I was offering all kinds of great benefits to the Adventurers Guild because they are a new client. But in doing so, I neglected my old clients. You're right. It's unfair. Let me do some market research. Wait here, my faithful assistants. I'll be back with you in a moment. It shouldn't take too long.
Paimon already told you we're not your assistants! Guess we got dragged into somebody else's business again. Let's look around while she's away.
Ugh, well, seems like Paimon's irritated by Hu-Tao. I'm not. I love her. That's why I'm gonna masquerade around as her now. Whee! Let's see, investigate the Wangsheng Funeral Parlor surroundings while waiting for Hu-Tao. We're not waiting for Hu-Tao, we're kind of running around the town with her right now. Wait, are we going up or higher? It says, okay, so we're going up the steps. Now it's saying lower. Why do I want to go lower? You just told me to go up, and now you're telling me to go down. Make up your mind, game, you're confusing me. Ugh. Let me see. Now we're going farther away. Oh, yeah, yeah. Eh, just go up the steps. Let's see. Are we going... No, it's still saying go lower. I don't remember how to get over there. Alright, I'm going lower. Alright, I think I'm going the right way now. Okay, here we go. I don't know why I traveled all that way. Examine board. A board used for hanging Wangsheng Funeral Parlor's wooden tiles. According to Hu-Tao, all the tiles should be blank. In which case, the characters on the back of the tiles must be the special offer, in quotations. Investigate the Wangsheng Funeral Parlor surroundings while waiting for Hu-Tao. Okay. So now we have to do... Oh, we gotta talk to this person now.
Be the director's new hires.
Not us! We're just very curious about Wangsheng Funeral Parlor and Hu-Tao.
Well, I wouldn't get too curious if I were you. Too much knowledge isn't good for ordinary folk. The director is tactful when it comes to what should and shouldn't be known.
Her? Tactful?
Okay, so that's two down, three to go, so there's one more thing to do. And that's going here, apparently. So, behind this door is Wangsheng Funeral Parlor. It looks far more ordinary than the director made it out to be.
We should get going. Let's go find Hu-Tao.
What are you talking about? She's right here. There she is. No, she's talking about this Hu-Tao.
That's settled then. Write it like this. Wangsheng Funeral Parlor Bumper Sale. Buy one, get one free. Buy two, get three free. More for your Mora. I love it. Better than all that lifeless brochure stuff. We want people to feel warm and fuzzy.
But director, isn't lifeless the name of the game in this industry?
That's old hat. We're opening up new ground.
Why does Wangsheng Funeral Parlor need to open up? Yes, director.
Poor guy's giving up.
Right, we should get going. I am not letting new business escape us.
We? As in us?
Who else? Do you see anyone else around here? Oh, well, you probably wouldn't see them if there was.
Stop adding little afterthoughts like that! It creeps people out.
Just a joke, sorry. Everything you see is everything that's present. For the moment, at least.
Comforting.
Lighten up. The way I see it, people make death scarier than it really is. What people truly fear about departing this world is suffering and regret. To deal with the trauma, they let their imaginations run wild with notions of ghosts and evil spirits. Oh, baseless fantasies. What we've ended up with is a topic that people are morbidly afraid of talking about. If I don't broach the subject, then Wangsheng Funeral Parlor won't be long for this world.
But I've seen a ghost.
Oh, more approachable and appeasable than you'd imagined?
Paimon wouldn't say that. Let's just say at least it didn't hurt us.
You must have come across a particularly ferocious entity. How should I put this? Most spirits are incapable of harming ordinary folks. The job of Wangsheng Funeral Parlor is to guard the border between life and death. One component of this is correcting notions of death and the afterlife that people may hold. Simply put, for those unable to see the border, they're best kept as far away from it as possible. So for ordinary folks, the best case scenario is ignorance of all matters concerning spirits in the afterlife, or even better, a belief that none of it exists.
Then you really don't have any excuse for spooking the heck out of people.
You make it sound so abominable. I'm just trying to get them to see the humor in it all.
There's not a whole lot of humor to be had when it comes to death, you know, Hu-Tao. Anyways, I've yet to see the funny side.
I never thought you'd be such a bore. Never mind. If you stick by me, everything will become clear. All right, let's get going. Follow me.
Will do.
Director, wait. What about Big G? Don't forget.
Big G? Who's that? We've been in Lila for ages and never heard that name.
Oh, nothing. Just something Mung's been pleading with me to take care of. Should be a piece of cake.
Where are we going?
That piece of cake smells...
important potential client. I'll lead the way.
As I was going to try to say, that piece of cake sounds good. I didn't mean to say smells good. But cake can smell good if it's cooked very well. let's see. Visit a potential client with Hu-Tao. And said client is right over here. Little Wu. Wu from FGO? Nope.
Sorry, who are you?
Hello, I'm Hu-Tao, director of the Wangsheng Funeral Parlor.
Okay, so why would someone from Wangsheng Funeral Parlor be looking for me?
No Nothing major. How are you feeling these days? Any aches or pains? You shouldn't ignore them, by the way. Very often, they're an omen of something terminal. When we're healthy, it's easy to forget the crushing fragility of life. So, aches and pains, best to keep an eye on them.
What are you getting at? I'm in great health and enjoying life very much, thank you. Go and find some other poor soul. Goodbye.
Why did they get angry? What's wrong with a few earnest health tips?
Hyman thinks it's because they're coming from the director of a funeral parlor.
Yeah, Hu-Tao not exactly the smoothest talker, but she is trying to run a business, so can't really get on her about that. Perhaps we can aid her, and that's what we're going to try and do. Continue visiting potential clients. Alright, where is the next client, speaking of which? Let's check the map. Yeah, they're right next to this teleporter. Very handy, let's go. Saves us a little bit of travel. Okay, we gotta go south. Oh, right over here.
And you are? Be quick, I'm busy.
Hello there. Would you be interested in understanding a bit about our services at the Wangsheng Funeral Parlor?
Wangsheng Funeral Parlor? I'm not in need of your services. So you're out here looking for new customers? Don't you think this might be a bit of a crass way of going about it?
Hardly. Isn't this the fashion these days? Bring the service to the customer and all that.
I'm not sure it's every service that falls into that. Anyway, please bother someone else if you don't mind.
Another failure. Still, not the end of the world.
Paimon's curious. Does this approach ever work out for you?
I'm gonna say probably not. And usually it's not wise to go around ask anybody for funeral services when clearly there's no one that is like deathly ill. Because usually they would be coming to you about that. let me see. Yeah, I'll go back to the map again. Oh. And the next mission's right next to the teleporter again. So why do I bother wandering away from it? Let's see, lower. Oh, okay, follow the sparkle trail. Yeah, the game's pretty nice about that, in case you're confused and don't really know where to go. Follow the sparkly trail and it'll take you where you need to go next. It doesn't pop up all the time, but sometimes it will. And for new players, that could be a godsend.
Someone needs assistance. I'll catch up.
And we're gonna jump over the table and talk to her.
I know your face. The Wangsheng Funeral Parlor Director, right? I'm sorry, I'm really in no need of it.
Don't apologize, get to know us. We've got a new sale going on. Ever hear the saying, out with the old, in with the new? Well, going out with a bang is the best way to start off in style on the other side.
If you keep talking like this, I'll have to call the Millilith.
No. Okay, relax. We're leaving. But Wangsheng Funeral Parlor awaits your distinguished patronage.
You really don't give up, do you?
Tough crowd.
Are you trying to make me feel better? Well, thank you. Seems you understand me far better than most people.
Not really. This is just getting really uncomfortable.
Enough business development. Please help me find someone.
Business development? Is that what you see this as? Surely you don't think all that was business development.
Then what was it exactly? Traumatization for its own sake?
No. The business development ended after the discussion with the Adventurers Guild. I was helping to find somebody for Meng. You remember Big G?
Rings a bell.
As it turns out, the Big G that Meng is looking for is a ghost adrift in the mortal realm. The three we saw just now were all people I suspected of being followed by Big G. But having seen them, I didn't sense the presence of anything otherworldly. So we just had a quick chat, and I left it at that.
If that was stopping for a quick chat.
Why didn't you say so? Paimon thought you had some kind of sixth sense for, people in declining health.
Huh? What would I need that kind of ability for? I'm no doctor. Were you seriously hoping that the director of the Wangsheng Funeral Parlor was going to start healing people, or...?
Paimon was trying to subtly imply that... never mind. Paimon wouldn't know how to explain subtlety in a way you'd understand.
Well, let's leave that for now and head back to Wangsheng Funeral Parlor. This Big G matter is very closely linked to Meng...